Good morning. Well now. Ho, ho, ho. I don't think, but there you go. I think I'm going to have glasses for this. Love. Romans chapter 12, verses 9 to 21. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil, cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in brotherly love. Honor one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with God's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud, but be willing to associate with people of low position. Do not be conceited. Do not repay anyone evil for evil. Be careful to do what is right in the eyes of everybody. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Do not take revenge, my friends, but leave room for God's wrath. For it is written, it is mine to avenge, I will repay, says the Lord. On the contrary, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals on his head. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Amen. Well, I was shafted yesterday yet again. The poor little magistrate, I tried to explain to him, there were three of them, two men and a woman, at Newcastle Quayside here in Newcastle. Magistrates, obviously. About the Lord's Prayer that... forgive us our trespasses as we forgive them that trespass against us. Well, you cannot nor must not go to God to pray. And I pray the Lord's Prayer every day, several times depending. If you are harbouring ill against anyone, you must try and reconcile with them. And I think whilst I tried to speak in the court as a Christian, first of all, he'd said, I said, well, I'm a Christian, the beginning of the proceedings. The magistrate says, well, so am I, and that's the end of that then, with his very words. And then the proceedings proceeded. And he said, if you don't keep quiet, you may leave the room, basically. So I was completely, my truth simply was not heard yesterday. I'm now banished from the whole of Alnwick town in Northumbria until the late February next year. So sort of 4.5 months. More banishment. So, I have to make another plan. Join all the other people evicted from their homes. And the other one is Matthew, of course. In this context, in the Beatitudes. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. Well, I'd endured pretty much 2.5 weeks of persecution by those neighbours at, I was at number 26, Annett Square, NE66, 1TR. I actually know the postcode. And of course, Michael was known, St. Michael, for slaying the naughty bad angels. So I latched onto that a bit as well. There clearly was drugs dealing going on there at that square, and I blew the whistle. I think I was arrested 5 times by the police. I'd had to put in 6 999 calls for various assaults upon me in various ways, without going into all the details, by these neighbours, those neighbours, whatever. They'd put a 666 on my doorstep, which is the devil's number. Nothing doing from the police. And one wonders why. I think the police are involved in the drug stealing. Basically, they can't be that incompetent. You can't go around calling a man a paedophile to his face, throwing rocks at his window, and not get done for harassment. Why didn't they do that? Plus the utter invention, I meant to have thwacked a little 4-year-old with, this is another staff I've cut, it's a better one actually. The whole point is, Christ says if they strike you on one cheek, give unto them the other cheek. Every single hair on the head of your fellow man, woman, and child is precious and special. I can't even think of thwacking someone, ever, because then I've lost the plot as a Christian. So the idea of thwacking a child is a massive insult. It really is such an insult to my spirit. I didn't even see the child on the day in question, and this woman has totally invented it. But of course I was arrested, and then that sort of emboldened and empowered them to invent more lies. And it's extraordinary how in the court, there you go in thinking you're such and such a kind of fellow, and by the time you come out, you've been painted as this entirely different human being altogether by the prosecution solicitor. I mean, all he wants to do is get his brownie points for getting another conviction. I cannot believe that they've thrown me out like this. I've got acute heart failure, real problems with my left leg, awaiting a big knee operation. Both legs, I've got cellulitis, occasioned by this, the police and everything, hoiking me around, stuffing me in police meat wagons. It is just utterly appalling. And I have no recourse to any sort of justice in this foul little Ingerland. People have been done to much worse than me. I'm sitting comfortably in this nice hotel room. I'm still a free man, and I will speak. Now watch that blasted little man, Rishi Sunak, shaking his money tree, or not, as the case may be. The Chancellor of the Exchequer, lining himself up to be the next Prime Minister of Britain, I think. Oh, yes, you're lovely. They'll get their comeuppance. So, onwards and upwards. I'm on the train south out of Northumbria, Newcastle. I shall be sleeping in the porch of the Baptist Church in St. Albans, as is my wont. I'll be independent there. Dat am die story, man. Funny old story, innit? Hey, to anyone who cares to listen to my blooming nonsense. Cheerio.